Welcome to Cubs Classics. I'm Cole Wright. Over the next few hours, we're going to relive one of the most memorable games in this storied franchise's history. All the passion and emotion, it's going to come rushing back. And we're going to experience it right here, and we'll do so together. After an 11-year stint in Atlanta, Greg Maddux, he returned to the Cubs to help form a formidable rotation that also featured the likes of Carlos Zambrano, Kerry Wood, and Mark Pryor. Now, a long and successful career gave Maddux the opportunity to do something that no one had achieved in 80 years. Record win number 300 in a Cubs uniform. Grover Cleveland Alexander was the last to do so all the way back in 1924. Now, the professor was making his second start since winning number 299. His first attempt, a no decision against Philly. So let's head to San Francisco to watch the Mad Dog go for the milestone.
Now, 299 wins in the Hall of Fame career of Greg Maddux. Four consecutive Cy Young Awards. His first came with the Cubs in his last season as a Cub, then won three in a row thereafter in Atlanta. Came back to the Cubs this season. In his career, he has struggled most frequently in the first inning. It's strike one to Ray Durham. And it's interesting to note, the Giants have scored more first inning runs than in any other inning during their season this year.
And Ray Durham with six leadoff homers this year.
80 runs this season in the opening inning for the Giants. And Maddux in his career has allowed 286 runs in the first, the most of any inning. Two balls and a strike. And that held true last week when Maddux went for win number 300 the first time against Philadelphia. He gave up a couple of home runs in the opening inning. In the air, right field by Durham. Drifting back is Sosa. Not going to get it off the wall. This may be three. Durham making a turn. Coming to third. He's in there with a triple.
Ray Durham has the kind of power that could be a number three or maybe a number five hitter. Felipe Alou has messed around with the idea of that, but his speed at the top of the order is something that he relishes and wants to have him at the top of that order. Look at the swing. That ball out over the middle of the plate. Durham thought he had a chance, and then off the bricks out there, he says this is going to be an easy triple with the kind of speed that Durham has.
Sixth three-base hit of the season for Ray Durham, and now Ricky Lede getting the start today in right field. The Cubs infield conceding the run unless it's hit right to the third baseman Aramis Ramirez. You see him there, a step on the grass at third. Everybody else will give away the run and take the out.
A glaring contrast in these two ball clubs, Tom. The Giants get the hits or do the fundamental things to get runners in when they have them on base. The Cubs have done a poor job of that throughout the entire season, of moving runners over and getting them in when they have to.
Those were the numbers we mentioned a moment ago before the leadoff triple by Durham, who stands at third with nobody out. Rolled foul by Lede, 2-1. Told you Maddux trying to become the 22nd pitcher in Major League history to record 300 wins. He would be the first National League pitcher to accomplish the feat since Steve Carlton 21 years ago. 2-2 on Lede. He would be the second Cub to reach the milestone, as Grove old Pete Alexander also did so in his last win of the 1924 season. Coincidentally, it came against the Giants.
Tommy, I think the very real possibility exists that we will never see another 300-game winner. Possibly Tommy Glavine, his former teammate, who needs 41 more victories. Glavine is the type of guy that will pitch until his arm falls off to get the 300.
Fouled away. Still 3-2 on Lede.
Check out the scouting report on Greg Maddux. Throws strikes early in the count. That's why he conserves his arm, doesn't have to throw many pitches. He's the master of control. We all know that. He works both sides of the plate as good as anybody. And the changeup is the equalizer. And when you watch that Fox box and you see the 83 miles an hour, that's his fastball. That's the change.
And gone swinging is Lede for the first out of the inning.
Watch the movement of the changeup. down and away from the left-handed hitter. So difficult to pick up. The hand motion, circle change, letting it roll off the outer fingers, the pinky fingers, as you pronate the arm and get the ball to spin the other direction.
Tall talons now for Maddux. It's JT Snow. One of the hottest hitters in all of baseball since coming off the DL June the 25th. He's hit 365 and he looks at strike one.
He was talking yesterday and said, you know, nobody ever really talks about you when you're in the lineup every day. And then when you're not in the lineup, as he has been in and out, he says they only talk about you when you're not playing if you're hitting well. He said that's the way it's been right now, and I still haven't been able to get in that lineup consistently.
Fastball in, one and one. Barry Bonds waiting in the on deck circle. Runner at third, one out here in the bottom of the first inning. There's a cut fastball that Maddux starts at a left-handed hitter. It looks as though it's going to hit the left-handed hitter and then moves back over the inside part of the plate. It is a devastating pitch. It's a beautiful pitch to watch on television. Bottom fell out of that pitch. Gone swinging. Are they saying foul tip? He foul tipped.
Maddux certainly, over the history of the game, is not the only guy to try that pitch. Here's a changeup that JT Snow just gets a piece of. But certainly over the last 19 seasons, Maddux has been the best at that comeback fastball that you were talking about. Throw it in off the belt buckle of a left-handed hitter, watch it tail back and nip the inside part of the plate. It freezes left-handers. They can't pull the trigger on it.
Big pitch here from Maddux. Runner at third, one out in the inning, and the 2-2 coming to JT Snow. Full count. Barry Bonds has hit more career home runs against Greg Maddux than any other batter the right-hander has faced in his career. Barry waiting in the on-deck circle. Payoff pitch to Snow. Is ball four. Bonds may get a chance to swing the bat. Well, the amazing Barry Bonds. With two on and one out here in the opening inning. In the air, straightaway center field. It'll stay in the park, but bring a run in. Patterson shy of the track. Tagging and scoring, Ray Durham. Give Bonds his 67th run batted in. Giants lead 1-0.
What we talked about a moment ago, the fundamental baseball that the Giants play. If they get a guy on base, they find a way to get him in. They get the clutch hits, they get the clutch sacrifice flies. As you watch Bonds, as that ball tails away from him, gets it out off the end of the bat a little bit, but does the job and gets the run home.
So Maddux surrendering a run here in the opening inning. And the Giants, as if on cue, have scored more runs in the opening inning than any other inning this season. And an early 1-0 lead. But look at Maddux in his career, the ERA in the first, then all the other innings this season. An earned run average in the first inning of over six, and thereafter under 3.5. It's an old adage in baseball, if you're going to get the great ones, you better get them early. 1-0 the count on Edgardo Alfonso. Low and away, but called a strike on the outside corner. We talk about it all the time. The pitcher's mound is the only place in professional sports where a person that is going to work on the field or on the court in any other game, the pitcher never gets the chance to go out at that exact position on the field and get warmed up for a game, to prepare for a game. The shortstops, they take ground balls, and basketball, they'll shoot at both ends of the courts. Tennis, golf, you'll have practice rounds. A pitcher warms up in the bullpen and gets maybe 8 throws from the pitching mound.
And pitchers will tell you that those mounds vary from ballpark to ballpark without question.
1-2. And now the count even on Edgardo Alfonso. Incidentally, this season, when Greg Maddux has allowed at least a run in the first inning, his record is 1-5 in those starts. Still 2-2.
Got away with a mistake right there. That ball out over the plate for Alfonso. Maddux so far in this inning struggling with that control we talked about. Look at where it's set up. And that ball is right down Broadway. Thrown 25 pitches already in this inning, which is also very uncharacteristic of a Maddux ball game.
2-2 to Edgardo Alfonso. And it's muscled down the left field line. It'll fall in fair for a base hit. Alou giving chase. On his way to third, JT Snow, and pulling up with a double, Edgardo Alfonso.
Maddux trying to get in on Alfonso. This ball's going to tail in on the hands, but watch Alfonso just pull the hands quicker and closer to his body. Watch the adjustment in the swing and just muscle that ball into left field. Worked hard to try to get the fat part of the bat on that ball, even though he still got jammed. He got enough on it to get it over the head of the third baseman and down the line for a double.
Maddux had to leave his last start pitching against the Phillies on a brutally hot and humid day. At the end of 6 innings, he was just gassed. He said maybe I could have gone out there and hoped they hit the ball at somebody, but he was more concerned about his team winning the game, which the Cubs wound up doing. But a pile of pitches here in the opening inning today on a much more pleasant weather day. Strike one to A.J. Pierzynski.
In that same ball game, Sammy Sosa came out of the ball game late with dizziness. You don't see Sammy Sosa coming out of too many ball games.
A.J., a .371 batter with runners in scoring position, fourth best in the National League. And that one just missed it. Runners at second and third, and it's in the air down the left field line. That ball slicing away from Alou. And he makes a running grab. Running over the bullpen mound. What a play that was by Alou. But Maddux gives up a run. The Giants strand 2 and lead 1-0.
A typical day at Wrigley Field.
As Chicago natives would say, it was a beautiful early May day.
A flame-throwing Cubs rookie.
We have a treat for you today. A youngster from Texas will take the mound.
A game that made history.
What can you say?
This is what everybody comes for, to hopefully come to that special game.
Here comes the hook. Got him! 20 strikeouts!
Kerry Wood 20, Friday at 6 on Marquee Sports Network.
And we've upgraded her with the sonic shield and holographic mapping drones.
Impressive.
There is one more thing.
Ah, Jake from State Farm.
Here's the deal. With the Drive Safe and Save app, you'll also get rewarded for being a safe driver.
Now that is an upgrade.
Well played, Jake from State Farm. As usual.
When you want the real deal, like a good neighbor, State Farm is there.
People from Chicago pull for Chicago. We root for his teams, celebrate his successes, push through his challenges. When people call us the second city, it's misleading. We're second to none. We're hardworking, resilient, but we have a good time. When you live in Chicago, you proudly call this home. Your bank should too. We're Wintrust, built here for here. And we've taken our place as Chicago's bank because no other bank can say the same.
Attention, guardians of the grass, navigators of the turf, and keepers of the green. To the mowers of Green Acres, rural ramblers, and back to the landers. Whether you saddle up or buckle down, run with us. To the kid corralers, grill masters, and all those who ride faster, run with us on a John Deere mower. Because this is more than just grass. It's home. Nothing runs like a deer. Receive a free trimmer rack with the purchase of any Z700 Series Z-Track mower.
We've always had villains to face.
Bad guys to take down. But you?
You're worse than all of them put together. You are the most horrible of all.
Pure evil.
But just because you're tough
doesn't mean we can't beat you.
We're not here because we have to be. We're here because we've had enough of you.
Every single one of us is mortal.
Even me. But inside of us, we're all heroes. One person is not a team.
But when we join together...
Together. You don't stand a chance.
We are glorious. We are resilient.
And we will win.
So stand up with us. Stand up to fight.
To stand up to cancer. Visit standuptocancer.org to learn more.
Dusty Baker manages San Francisco Giants from 1993 through the 2002 season. Now in his second year in Chicago, he took the Giants to the playoffs three times during his 10 years. And then last year, finally got a postseason series win when they knocked off Atlanta in the division series in five games. And lost that heartbreaking National League Championship Series in seven to the Florida Marlins.
And I don't know if you're like me, Tom, but on that last play to end the first inning where Moises Alou hustled all the way over the right field line, almost tripping over the mound and getting close to the seats when he caught that ball, flashes of Steve Bartman running through my head.
I am sure you are not alone. Swing and a miss by Aramis Ramirez. And Brad Hennessy making his major league debut. Has allowed just one hit, gotten strikeouts on Sosa, now Ramirez.
Watch the spin of the slider. You can see the dot that the hitters try to pick up. From center field now, the late movement. That's the pitch that is his bread and butter. He can throw that slider for a strike at almost at will. And he's had pinpoint control of it so far today.
Derek Lee looks at ball one. Lee having an outstanding year, coming over from the defending world champion Florida Marlins. 298 batter, 22 home runs, 66 batted in. 1-1. A rough night last night for Big Derek. Up against Jason Schmidt, who struck him out four times. High hopper to third. Alfonso throws high, and it's into the stands. Lee will be awarded second base.
This is a play that just sets up for disaster. He had to wait on this play. Now he knows he's going to have to hurry, and he just airmails it. Most infielders, if they have to try to throw the ball too hard, if they get out of their normal rhythm of throwing the ball, they either hang on to it too long and throw it hard into the dirt, or they release too early, as you see right there, and the ball just sails on you and gets up over everybody's head.
Is the idea to charge and get it before it takes that second hop?
I don't think he could have done that, because then he would have made it a do-or-die play that he didn't have to.
Todd Walker in the lineup at second base today. And looks at ball one down low. Walker can hit. No two ways about that. A 285 batter, 13 home runs, 35 batted in. One of the stars for the Boston Red Sox during their run through the American League playoffs last year, losing in seven, of course, to the Yankees. 1-1. The Brad Hennessy story is just an amazing sequence of events after being the Giants' number one draft pick, the 21st pick overall in 2001. They sent him to rookie ball. He pitched there about 30 innings after being drafted. Then he went down to the Instructional League in Arizona. He'd go to bed every night, could barely roll over. His back hurt so bad. Was in tremendous pain all the time. Doctors looked him over and thought maybe it pulled a muscle, whatever the case may be, and let it ride out and didn't pitch him anymore during the Instructional League. When he came back to spring training the following year, it still hurt. So they decided to take a look, underwent an MRI, and they found out that he had a benign tumor, as Steve mentioned earlier, on his spinal cord. It required not one but two surgeries to get it out of there. So he missed all of 2002, came back last year for 15 games, and thank God been healthy ever since. 3-1 to Walker, his ball four high.
I think a lot of the people were talking about whether or not he'd be nervous, number one, in his first major league start, which brings a lot of nervousness with it. But going up against Maddux, going for his 300th win, when you sit in a doctor's office and the guy looks across the table at you and says you have a tumor in your back, I don't think this game's scaring him too much.
Lead the runner at second, Todd Walker on at first, and now Paul Bacco. A 198 batter, only six runs batted in. Bacco has pretty much become the personal catcher with the Cubs for Greg Maddux, as he was when the two were in Atlanta. There's ball one down low to Bacco.
Talking to Chip Carey, the broadcaster of the Cubs, and he was talking about Bacco and Barrett, the job that they have done, and everyone assumes because the pitching staff is so good that they're easy to catch. He says they're not easy to catch. You either have a bunch of hard throwers that are a little unpredictable and sometimes wild, like Wood can be. Pryor has probably the most poise and control. Zambrano's tough to catch. Maddux, with the late movement on all his pitches, these guys are tough to catch. Not an easy staff to handle.
Throw in Matt Clement as well.
You got that.
1-1 to Bacco. Fouled out of play, a ball and two strikes. Two on, one out. Hennessy looking in, ahead in the count to Bacco at a ball and two strikes. And it tails away at even the count. Two and two to Bacco. Two on, one out. Pulled to Snow. There's one. And a soft throw down to second. Didn't have a lot on it. And easily sliding in safely on what was a tag play after tapping the bag at first is Todd Walker.
I mean, this is just a great play by a Gold Glove first baseman. Watch him get the out first then, and then lob the ball over the runner. He doesn't want to hit the runner in the back. Still possible to have a chance to make a play down there. If the ball bounces off the back, Lee scores from third base and you're in trouble. That's like putting a little air under a football when you have to make a touch pass just over a middle linebacker. An outstanding play, even though he didn't get the out down there at second.
Now Greg Maddux has always been not only a great pitcher, he has been a great defender and has been a pretty darn good hitter. I mean, if you could clone a pitcher, most people would want that guy who throws 95, 97 miles per hour, i.e. Randy Johnson, Jason Schmidt, and the like. I'm not so sure if you had to clone a pitcher that this wouldn't be the guy that you would clone. Everything you want. 13-time Gold Glove winner, swings the bat, great stuff, and maybe most importantly of all, a phenomenal competitor.
I would think that that's what he would say is his greatest attribute, is being a student of the game and the tenacity behind it. I mean, they call him the professor. Weighs about 185 pounds, wears glasses when he's not on the field, looks very unintimidating, and then just beats you up.
One and two, the count on Maddux. Runners at second and third. And it's away to even the count. Corey Patterson standing in the on-deck circle. Hennessy trying to put Maddux away and keep it a 1-0 ball game. 2-2 pitch. Strike three called on a breaking ball to end the inning. An error, two left. Three strikeouts for the kid. 1-0 Giants.
Stop into Menards and start your next project today. Update your bathroom with a new Delta faucet. The Dawson Bath Faucet features a channel spout design and comes in a brushed nickel finish. Right now, just $109.99. This Stratton vanity offers an on-trend gray finish paired with a stylish door and drawer profile, making it ideal for any decor. On sale today for only $229.99. These deals are going on now. During Menards, think spring sale.
Save big money at Menards.
The whole world's waiting for your solution.
I hate to spoil the ending, but everything's gonna be just fine.
And the best part is, we've been carrying it the whole time.
Cadillac invites you to move up in the world at the Cadillac Move Up sales event. Move up to available Wi-Fi hotspot capability. Move up to cutting-edge design. Move up to something a little more, well, Cadillac. Make your way to your nearest Cadillac showroom today. During the Move Up sales event, get this low-mileage lease on this 2020 Cadillac XT5 for around $419 per month.
The 2016 Run for the Ring on Marquee Sports Network is proudly presented by Blue Cross Blue Shield, First Midwest Bank, and Advocate Aurora Health.
I need new struts for my 2010 Chevy. Let me see struts by AC Delco, KYB, and any under $50.
We might be able to get some struts from the warehouse.
Why watch the counterman tap on his computer and hope he chooses the right part? Go to rockauto.com. Auto and body parts from hundreds of manufacturers. Choose the brands, prices, and features you want. Auto parts at the lowest price. Conveniently delivered to your home or business.
All the parts your car will ever need, Rock Auto.
2016 Run for the Ring on Marquee Sports Network is proudly presented by Wintrust, Miller Lite, and Hyundai.
Giants come to bat bottom half of the second inning against Greg Maddux, leading 1-0, and it's ball one to Marquise Grissom. Latter third in the batting order coming up. Grissom, Davey Cruz, and Brad Hennessy. Maddux threw 29 pitches in the opening inning. On the ground down to third. Ramirez throws high, but Lee makes a tag for the first out of the inning. Grissom set down to open up the second inning, and here comes Davey Cruz. Boy, what a year this guy's had. Basically saw zero playing time early in the year when the Giants brought him on board. But carries a .290 batting average with 24 runs batted in. Garcia Parra throws in time for out number two. Brad Hennessy looks at a fastball, strike one.
We were talking earlier about checking out the Fox box at the top of your screen and the miles per hour on that. A lot of times Maddux's fastball will look like everyone else's changeup. 83 miles an hour. In the playoffs last season, when we had Josh Beckett throwing a 97 mile an hour fastball and a 90 mile an hour change.
Yeah. Same thing we saw from Jason Schmidt here last night.
And Schmidt has become basically a two-pitch pitcher, and that's what he uses.
2-1 delivery is high. Three balls and a strike to Hennessy. Well, Maddux cruising along here. Getting Grissom on a ground ball to third. Cruz on a grounder to short and only thrown four pitches to get the first two outs of the inning. And now has gone 3-1 on his counterpart, Brad Hennessy. Boy, how about being Brad Hennessy? Maybe not later today, but right now. Bottom of the second inning, you're beating Greg Maddux. You face him at the plate, and you're on base. Well, September 7, 1986. Look at Greg Maddux, old Riverfront Stadium. His first win, a complete game against the Cincinnati Reds. He allowed 11 hits and 3 runs. Sal Butera ending that game on a double play ball. Sean Dunston, Ryan Sandberg and company coming over to say attaboy. 298 wins ago.
Maybe it's possible that in 19 seasons from now we'll be rolling back this game. Talking about Hennessy's very first victory.
You never know. You never know.
I'll tell you what, Tom, Maddux so far in the early going is really struggling with location. We talked about that in his scouting report. He owns both sides of the plate, has had trouble hitting the corners today.
2-1 to Ray Durham. .41 pitches now for Maddux, and there you see the balls and strikes, Steve, precisely what you were just talking about. Only one more strike than ball. Pull foul. Ball dude down there a little tardy. It's hard to get off those little seats they give them, though. They got to keep them low enough not to block the fans sitting right behind them.
It's not the seat. It was hard to get his stomach out of the way to go over there and make that play.
Now, why do you got to be that way?
It's the truth.
2-2 to Durham. Popped up. Man, you are cold. Left side of the infield. Garcia Parra's got it. Nomar and company coming up in the third.
When you run a business in Chicago, you have to be ready to put in the hours, put in the work, brave the elements. Running a business here comes with ups and downs. The downs make you tougher. The ups keep you pushing. At Wintrust, we know what that's like because we started here too, with one small location and have found a way forward. No one knows how to support a Chicago business like another. From us to you, keep going. We've got your back.
We've always had villains to face.
Bad guys to take down. But you.
You are the most horrible of all.
We're not here because we have to be.
We're here because we've had enough of you.
Every single one of us is mortal.
But inside of us, we're all heroes.
So stand up with us. Stand up to fight.
Stand up to cancer.
Visit standuptocancer.org to learn more.
Are you in a job you can't stand and are working too many hours for too little money? Do you want a rewarding career with great growth potential? By attending My Computer Career, in as little as 4 months, you could be starting your new career in the growing IT field. Classes meet on campus or live online just twice a week. Go to mycomputercareer.edu and fill out the free career evaluation right now. You don't need to be a math or computer whiz at mycomputercareer.edu, and no experience necessary at mycomputercareer.edu.
And our question is for Javi. Why are you
so cute?
Marquee Sports Network presents Best of Kids Press Conference from Cubs Convention 2020. Get honest, hard-hitting answers to your Cubs questions that only kids would dare to ask.
What's your longest home run you ever hit?
I have a question for Rizzo. Will you be my Valentine?
Marquee Sports Network, a network as dedicated as you. Friday at 11 on Marquee Sports Network.
are the census. A special time when we count every person in each home in every neighborhood.
Do kids count?
Of course. Counting everyone in your home helps support your neighborhood by funding things like schools, hospitals, and buses. Complete the census by calling or going online, or return your form by mail.
It's easy, secure, and most important, it's totally private.
Make your family count!
This year, make sure every child counts. Visit 2020census.gov.
Top of the order coming up for Chicago here in the third inning. Giants leading 1-0. Brad Hennessy began the year at Double-A, moved up to Triple-A, and now in his big league debut squaring off with Greg Maddux, who's looking for his 300th career win. And so far, so good for the 24-year-old native of Toledo, Ohio. Pitched at Youngstown State University. There's a strike to Patterson, 0-2.
The Youngstown State Penguins. Strike some fear in your heart when you're playing them.
I'm telling you. 1-2 to Patterson.
Patterson has worked very hard lately on bunting as you look at Hennessy's numbers right there.
Which he would have to do to get to 300 wins. We're going to put that back up there. I mean, just try to think about this for a minute. To get to 300 wins, this young man is only 24. Would have to average 21 wins per season the next 14 years. From now until 2018 to reach 300 wins by his 38th birthday.
Wow. Amazing.
Well, you look at what Maddux has done. 16 straight seasons with 15 wins or more. Unbelievable.
Roger Clemens a couple of years ago got to number 300, or last season, I beg your pardon, on his fourth try, you may remember, with the New York Yankees. Steve mentioned Tom Glavine at 259 and then Randy Johnson at 241. Johnson will be 41 years old in a little more than a month from now. Glavine in his late 30s.
Well, it's just impressive when you see the names of the great pitchers that we've come to know and love in this game and see that they're nowhere near 300 victories. Pedro Martinez. I mean, Pedro's been around for a long time. He's been a dominating force in the game. He's one of the best in the game. He's got 177 wins.
3-1 to Nomar on the ground to Davey Cruz. He bobbles, and Garcia Parra is safe at first. Second error of the game against the Giants' left side of the infield.
This ball takes a funny little hop on Davey Cruz. He's down on it. Watch the ball pop up. See where his glove is. Looks like he's right there. Pops up, hits him off the heel of the glove. And now he's unable to regroup and throw out Garcia Parra, who's hustling down the line as he always does.
Moise Salou fouled out down the left field line to Barry Bonds, his first time up. You know, getting back to that run by Maddux you were talking about a moment ago, it's obviously a testament to his greatness, which goes hand in hand when you're going to pile up that many wins with staying healthy. He's only been on the disabled list one time in his career, and that was for a foot injury, never an arm injury. Had some tenderness at back as well. But the other part of it, it's also, again, a reflection of the unrivaled success that the Atlanta Braves organization has had. All the years Maddux was there, they won their division every single year. They were winning 90 plus games a year. Runner goes, throw to second. And in there safely is Garcia Parra. His second stolen base since coming over from Boston.
I like the fact that Garcia Parra is running over here with the Cubs a little more than he was with the Red Sox. And it might be a little bit of the back and forth that's going on between the Boston media and the Boston organization and Garcia Parra. A little wink, wink about saying, my foot's just fine. My ankle's fine. My heel's good. I'm going to run. I'm feeling strong. Boy, Garcia Parra still leads the headlines in Boston on a daily basis, and he doesn't play for him anymore.
2-0, a strike call to Alou. The tying run out there at second base. One out here in the third inning. Well, that whole story, I mean, there is something really wrong about that story because somebody is not telling the truth and nothing even close to the truth.
And there's two aspects of it. When was he originally hurt? And was he thinking about going on the DL if he stayed in Boston?
And again, I don't know who's right and I don't know who's wrong, and we may never find out. But it is impossible to have the disparity to each side of the story that is going on as it pertains to Garcia Parra and his final season with the Boston Red Sox.
Well, one thing's for sure, wearing that Cub uniform and speaking to him yesterday as we did, I've never seen him smile more in recent times than he is right now.
Yep. Lined hard into center field, but right at Grissom. He's got it for the second out. Garcia Parra stays at second. Well, the Atlanta Braves are at it again, trying for their 13th consecutive divisional championship. Sammy Sosa, the batter, with a runner at second base and two away. Cubs trailing here in the third against Brad Hennessy, 1-0. Well, if you'd have seen the Atlanta Braves play at the end of April, at the beginning of May, you would have bet the ranch that that string of divisional championships would come to an end. Pulled foul by Sosa. One ball, one strike.
Here's what we talked about, Sammy Sosa. Look at the location of this pitch, right out over the middle. That's an aggressive swing from Sammy Sosa, but out front too far and just pulls it foul. That's a ball that Sammy knows that he should have hit hard and hit it in the field of play somewhere.
Hennessy's been very sharp thus far. Half the base runners against him have come on defensive miscues, one by Alfonso in the second, and Davy Cruz here in the third. He should be out of this inning right now. Instead, he's facing Sosa, representing the go-ahead run.
He's got options right here. He can throw a fastball up and into Sammy and get him off the plate, go fastball away, or the slider away and get him out right here on this pitch.
Slider away, got him out on that pitch.
How much dogs do you have?
I got 7 dogs.
Welcome to Bay versus Ballplayer.
Cubs win on a grand slam by Hayward.
You need something you can run to that makes you happy.
I think everybody hopes to play forever.
We're mic'd up.
I tried to play Fortnite. I downloaded it. No chance.
No.
Catch the best Cub moments every month with the Best of Cubs YouTube on Marquee Sports Network.
Sir, you cannot park there.
What? Why?
It's reserved for Chris Paul.
Barb, tell me what you not see.
My name's not Barb. You're not Chris Paul.
Stop it, Nancy. Woo!
That's not my name.
Can I see some ID?
This is my ID.
Need a tow truck on level 1? Oh, it's Jake from State Farm.
Here's the deal. There's no replacing the real Chris Paul, just like there's no replacing State Farm.
Marley, who took my spot?
Oh, just some guy. We're taking care of it.
Okay.
You want the real deal? Like a good neighbor, State Farm is there.
You might take something for your heart, your joints, or your digestion. So why wouldn't you take something for the most important part of you, your brain? With an ingredient originally discovered in jellyfish, Prevagen has been shown in clinical trials to improve short-term memory. Prevagen, healthier brain, better life.
Yeah.
MS does suck.
MS mucks with your central nervous system. Almost everything about your body, your muscles, your organs, your ability to speak, your ability to understand, your ability to move.
MS took everything from me. Everything I thought was important, everything I valued.
I used to jump in a trampoline and swim with the kids.
MS has affected me being a mom because I'm sorry.
Despite MS, I will keep riding my bike.
I will continue to be the strongest mom that I possibly can.
I will still dance with my husband.
I will continue to live the life that my daughter expects me to live.
Multiple sclerosis may be a part of who you are, but it doesn't define you.
I will never stop. I will never quit.
I'm going to keep being me.
Saturday afternoon at SVC Park in San Francisco. The Giants trying to spoil Greg Maddux's attempt at winning 300 games. First pitch swinging, a broken bat by Ricky Lede. One pitch and one out. Maddux trailing 1-0 in his second go-round for win number 300.
Wait, Tommy, we talk about the great reactions and the gold glove of Greg Maddux. I don't think he saw this bat come back at him. Look at the reaction. I don't think he picked that bat up until the very last second. Imagine if you don't see it, you don't pick it up, and it just comes straight back at you. Wow.
JT Snow lifts a fly ball down the left field line, and it is fair. Alou over to pick it up. And Snow a big turn, but will stop at first base with a one-out single. And now Barry Bonds. Well, Jim Maddux has surrendered the most home runs to Bonds than any other batter he's faced through the years. 8 of them. Walked him 22 times. Only Tony Gwynn, more base hits against Maddux than Barry Bonds. Low and away for ball one. Now, those numbers are a little bit deceptive in that the first 7 years Bonds was in the league against Maddux, Bonds wore him out. It has been a dramatically different story since then. Bonds has not even hit 200 against him since 1994.
And just two home runs in those 10 years as well.
There you get a look. 204 from 94 to now 04. Bonds, a sac fly RBI, his first time up today. And he looks at a strike. Bonds number 3 on the all-time home run list. Now 687. Next up, Babe Ruth at 714. And, of course, Henry Aaron, the all-time home run king at 755. A legitimate shot, more than legitimate shot now for Bonds.
Talk about Bonds' numbers against Maddux. If you look at the lineup that the Giants are throwing out there today against him, in their careers, they're 316 hitters against Maddux. Not too shabby.
Not bad at all.
3-1 to Bonds. And he draws a walk. It's amazing what Bonds has done not only in his career, but as he's gotten older, compared with some of the greats of all time. The numbers are overwhelming. Strike one to Edgardo Alfonso. Now, this is a little busy, but all you need to look at, the numbers there in the middle in yellow, the number of home runs that Bonds has hit the last 4 years of his career compared to roughly the same time frame for all the great sluggers or a handful of the great sluggers in the history of the game. Swinging a foul ball back. All of them at 40-something. Bonds just turned 40 on July the 24th. But 90 more home runs than the Babe.
Well, Babe looks good, though. Doesn't he?
He always looked good. 0-2 to Edgardo Alfonso with two on and one out. fouled out of play. Talking to Don Sutton last night. Sutton, of course, a 300-game winner in his career, a Hall of Famer, and had a chance to broadcast just about every game Greg Maddux pitched during his tenure with the Atlanta Braves. Don Sutton was always thought of as a professor-like out there on the mound during his career. Very smart, very heady, knew what was going on at all times around him. And he had a great line talking about Maddux last night. He said, "I thought that I knew what I was doing out there on the mound during my career." He said, "Compared to Maddux, I got an honors degree at a junior college." He said, "Maddux got a doctorate degree from an Ivy League school." Sutton said he's never seen or been around anyone like Greg Maddux out there on that mound. Pull foul.
Talking to Kent Merker earlier today about Maddux's changeup, and he says he really believes he throws two of them. With the position of his pinky finger on the ball, he says most of his changeups go down and away to a left-handed hitter. He said he's seen him cut that ball and make it act almost like a slider down and into a lefty by the way he places that last finger on it. And we watch the release point of this pitch right here out of the hand of Greg Maddux. You see the ball rotate in the opposite direction and go down and into a righty. Maddux says when that happens, if it goes down and into a lefty, it's by accident. Merker says no way.
Base hit in the right field by Alfonso. They're going to wave around JT Snow. Sosa's throw coming to the plate. Not going to be in time. Throw to third, and he's out there. So it's 2-0 Giants on the run-scoring single by Edgardo Alfonso. But Bonds cut down trying to go first to third. It didn't look like he was going first to third all that hard.
Now watch Bonds get to second. He's looking for this ball to come into the cutoff man. He has a good idea right here when he sees it's a high throw, but he gets a late jump doing it. As you mentioned, going from first to second, if he maybe had hustled a little bit more getting there, he would have had a better idea and would have viewed the play better on the opposite side of second base.
J. Brzezinski hammers one into right center field, and Sosa's not going to get it. On his way to third, Alfonso, they're going to wave him around. Here comes the throw to the plate. It gets by the cutoff man, and on to third goes Brzezinski. 3-0 Giants.
Brzezinski just hammers this ball. Look at location again. Way away from where Paul Bacco wanted that pitch. Sammy got no chance to catch this ball. It's hit way too hard. But if the fundamentals are there for the Cubs, they would get Brzezinski at third. This ball gets past the cutoff, man. You look at where Brzezinski is. He's dead at third if they just cut the ball off. Boy, that's a good sound, though. Brzezinski at that point may have been thinking, I'll trade the out, which will be me, for the run score. Meaning he would let them cut the ball off and get him out at third, but the run would score before he would be out.
Grissom, a slow roller foul up the third baseline. 3 runs and 5 hits for the Giants against Greg Maddux. His second try for his 300th career win. He got a no decision his last time out against Philadelphia. He allowed 3 runs, 2 of them earned in 6 innings, but just ran out of gas on a very hot day, threw only 87 pitches in the 6 innings. 1-1 to Grissom. A big series for the Giants. They moved Jason Schmidt up a day and got him a start here last night, trying to set the tone for this series, which he did with less than his best, admittedly so last night. But the Giants starting this series 3 games behind the Cubs in the wild card race. got the win, now within two, and they've got a 3-0 lead. And they have Maddux working hard.
Well, the thinking there was to get the first win of the series, and they did.
Two more in the giant third. They lead Maddux 3-0.
We are T-Mobile, the first to go unlimited. First with no annual service contracts. First with taxes and fees included. Now T-Mobile has the first and only nationwide 5G network, reaching over 5,000 cities and towns and over 200 million Americans. And T-Mobile is not charging extra for 5G access. Because this isn't our network, it's yours.
Attention, guardians of the grass, navigators of the turf, and keepers of the green. To the mowers of green acres, rural ramblers, and back to the landers. Whether you saddle up or buckle down, run with us. To the kid corralers, grill masters, and all those who ride faster, run with us on a John Deere mower. Because this is more than just grass. It's home. Nothing runs like a deer. Receive a free trimmer rack with the purchase of any Z700 Series Z-Track mower.
Cadillac invites you to move up in the world at the Cadillac Move Up sales event. Move up to available Wi-Fi hotspot capability. Move up to cutting-edge design. Move up to something a little more, well, Cadillac. Make your way to your nearest Cadillac showroom today. During the Move Up sales event, get this low-mileage lease on this 2020 Cadillac XT5 for around $419 per month.
Though human ingenuity will continue to make various inventions, with the help of new machines built to do the same, of this I am certain, no invention will ever be devised that is more beautiful, more simple, and more purposeful than those that nature designs. Proud server of the most advanced machine on Earth.
Free services to ensure your vehicle is ready when you are. Just one more way at Pep Boys. We go further to help you go farther. Before you hit the road, have Pep Boys check your brakes, tires, battery, fluids, and more free.
Allow us to reintroduce ourselves. A new retro-inspired look for the Great American Lager. This bud's for you.
When you live in Chicago, you proudly call this home. Your bank should too. We're Wintrust, built here for here. And we've taken our place as Chicago's bank because no other bank can say the same.
Here at SBC Park in San Francisco, where Brad Hennessy looking for his first big league win here today, besting Greg Maddux through the front three in a 3-0 lead. That one down the right field line, a fair ball off the bat of Aranis Ramirez. Throw in his second base offline, and Ramirez with a hustling double. And a broken back hustling double.
This is a scary play for a player running the bases. Ramirez sees the ball going down the right field line. So he's watching it, not really taking a turn. He's hustling. Now he has to make a quick turn and try to get to second base. That's how you roll your ankle over, hustling all the way into second for that double. You're running down the line begging for it to drop. You momentarily forget to take your little turn out so that you make a good turn going into second.
You know, Cub fans hold their breath because Ramirez missed nearly 2 weeks with a strained left groin and has been rather tender running around the bases ever since. Now big Derek Lee. First pitch fastball in the outside corner, strike one.
And Ramirez was probably the best number four hitter in the game when he went down with that injury. Look at the starting pitchers and their numbers so far. Not coincidentally is when the Cubs started to fade in the division race was the same time when Ramirez went down.
One and one to Derek Lee, reached on an error by Edgardo Alfonso his first time up. Runner at second, nobody out. Cubs trying to get back in it, trailing here in the fourth inning, 3-0.
We talked about the contrast between these two teams. This is a situation where the Cubs have struggled. Down 3-0 in this ball game with a guy on second base. You do have a guy in the middle of your order here that you expect to drive in runs, but at the very least, they have to move the guy over.
Which he's going to do and get him in, maybe. Base hit into right field. They're going to hold Ramirez at third base. So Lee had the right idea and gets a base hit out of it. Runners on the corners and nobody out.
Excellent, excellent job. You can see by the way the inside out swing. Watch him pull his hands in, drag the bat head through to try to make sure he gets the ball to the right side. Not only does he move the runner over, but he gets a base hit for himself. You keep the inning going, and now you got a chance to get something going. This is the type of baseball right there that the Cubs have not done very well this season.
Cubs have gone 13-9 since the All-Star break. They've been hot lately, winning 7 of their last 10. They were a 500 club during the month of July when they went from one game back to double digits back in the National League Central behind St. Louis, who incidentally won again today, beating the New York Mets 10-1.
How good is that club?
And they just added Larry Walker.
Yeah, because they needed him. That's what Mark Pryor was saying in the Cubs clubhouse today. He goes, yeah, they needed more sock in the lineup.
Pitch to Walker. Outside, ball one. Todd walked his first time up.
As we all know,
first test now for Hennessy here.
We all know it gets awfully, awfully hot in August in St. Louis. Same in Texas. May see some of those races closing up a little bit. The dog days are upon us.
Runner goes, and it's pulled down the right field line, and it is a fair ball. It'll go to the wall. Ramirez scores. Lee being waved around. He'll score. Walker on his way to third. A two-run triple, and it's a one-run game.
You said it before, Tommy. This kid can always hit. Boston didn't like his defense. You see Derek Lee at second base, not sure where that ball was. They couldn't pull it out of the corner, Ricky Ledet. But Walker can put his bat on the ball. Nice swing. You see Walker hustling to second base, looking behind him as Ledet could not pick the ball up in the corner, and he made his decision to move on to third.
Well, they're scoring that a double and then an error on the right fielder Ricky Ledet. He had a few problems down in that corner. That's why you saw Walker taking a peek back.
You know, and that's a play right there for a player that no one can help you with. The play isn't technically in front of you anymore because you're running to second base. That ball's down in the right field corner. You have to do it yourself. Can't really look at the third base coach for help in that situation. He's not any closer to the play than you are.
Now runner at third, nobody out. Paco trying to tie this game. And looks at ball one.
Look at what Ledet is doing down there. The ball bounces off the sign. He can't pick it up. Now he's thinking about following it around just to see what it eats.
Fouled out of play. Now Alfonso about even with a bag at third. Likewise for JT Snow over at first. Anything hit right at them if Walker breaks for the plate. And with a pitcher on deck, you got to believe he would be coming on contact. Middle infield conceding the run. Fly ball short left field. Bonds coming in to get it. And Walker not going to take the chance. Big out right there for Hennessy with a pitcher coming up.
This is a tough decision for any third base coach. We know Bonds does not throw well anymore. Walker, decent speed on third base. Bonds does a good job of just making an accurate throw to the cutoff man in case you have to relay it. Wendell Kim is come under a lot of fire in Chicago with his decisions at third base.
Well, now Felipe Alou is going to bring his infield in with Greg Maddux at the plate. Tying run at third, one away here in the top of the fourth inning. Maddux, a two-hopper at Durham, who bobbles and still got the out. Walker still standing there at third, two away in the inning.
A lot of people might be wondering, why are you not running on this play? But you don't. This is not a contact play. When the infield is in, the design is to make sure that you cut the run down at home plate. So as a runner on third base, the rule is you have to make sure the ball gets through the infield. If it does, you'll walk home. If it doesn't, you're dead at home plate.
Now Corey Patterson twice has bounced out to JT Snow. Big swing and a miss. Three runs, five hits for the Giants. Two runs, four hits for the Cubs against Brad Hennessy. Pitch number 71 on the way. And it's too low to even the count of the ball and a strike.
What do we talk about? The same type of fundamentals. We saw Derek Lee do an outstanding job of getting the runner to third base, and now unable to get him in.
Leaning on a two-out hit. And Hennessy ahead of Patterson and a ball and two strikes. Whoa, look out down there. Better go back, get that lid.
Watch this. This guy's auditioning to be the next bald dude. He speared it, spilled his beer. Ripped his pants, lost his lid. I think his body even took a bad hop. Look at this. That's not quite the way you do it.
Look at the ball, dude. They're backing up the play.
He was there. Now, you know what I like about here in San Francisco? They don't keep this guy out of the game. Innocent mistake.
Swing and a miss by Patterson to end the inning. The Cubs get two, but they had a tying run at third. Nobody out. Failed to get him in.
The network has to be prepared to absorb whatever is going to come its way.
We're always preparing.
Make sure that the network is working all the time.
We are constantly looking at it. We're constantly monitoring. Take that responsibility very seriously.
The most rewarding thing about the work we do is whenever we see a customer able to communicate back to their loved ones.
That is why we do what we do.
We're relentlessly committed to the network, so in times like this, America can stay connected to work, school, and most importantly, to each other.
Marquee Sports Network counts down the best games of all time. Was it Kerry Wood's 20 strikeout game?
Swing! Miss strike three. The Cubs have won the pennant.
Or the first night game at Wrigley Field.
Look at the lights flickering all over Wrigley Field.
Ernie Banks got number 500.
Cubs Countdown, Thursday at 3 on Marquee Sports Network.
We've always had villains to face,
bad guys to take down. But you,
you're worse than all of them put together. You are the most horrible of all.
Pure evil.
But just because you're tough
doesn't mean we can't beat you.
We're not here because we have to be. We're here because we've had enough of you.
Every single one of us is mortal.
Even me. But inside of us, we're all heroes. One person is not a team.
But when we join together,
you don't stand a chance.
We are glorious. We are resilient.
And we will win.
So stand up with us. Stand up to fight.
To stand up to cancer. Visit standuptocancer.org to learn more.
Hair. Such an underappreciated gift. Just look what you do to it. You sacrifice it. You wear it up. You cut it yourself.
You like it?
No.
Yet there's still one place that cares more about your hair than you will ever know.
show-offs.
And our question is for Javi. Why are you
so cute?
Marquee Sports Network presents Best of Kids Press Conference from Cubs Convention 2020. Get honest, hard-hitting answers to your Cubs questions that only kids would dare to ask.
What's your longest home run you ever hit?
I have a question for Rizzo. Will you be my Valentine?
Marquee Sports Network, a network as dedicated as you. Friday at 11 on Marquee Sports Network.
Giants come to bat here in the bottom half of the fourth inning. First pitch swinging, Davey Cruz, a high hopper down to Aramis Ramirez. One gone against Greg Maddux.
All right, now this is classic Maddux. Throws strikes early on and gets guys to take swings like this. That's an excuse me hack on the first pitch of the at bat. There are a lot of first pitch swingers. I was myself, but you got to get a better pitch than that. If you're going to go up hacking on your first pitch, you got to get dead red and air it out.
Ball one to Brad Hennessy, who walked his first time up. Three runs and five hits for the Giants against Maddux. Two runs, four hits for the Cubs against Brad Hennessy. A ball and a strike. Maddux, a Cubs second round draft choice back in 1984. The scout who signed him, Doug Mapson. Got him out of Valley High in Las Vegas. High hopper foul up the third baseline. Spent 84 in Pikeville, 85 in Peoria, 86. Started in Double A, went to Triple A, came to the major leagues. Told you he got his first complete game win against Cincinnati that year. The following year, he lost 14 games and had an ERA of over 5.5. Now, do you think anybody could have honestly told you, and there are those that will tell you, hey, I thought he'd be a good pitcher. Dick Pohl, now the bullpen coach for the Cubs, and of course, he'd been around a long, long time, and he was Maddux's pitching coach, both in the minor leagues and at the major league level with the Cubs. Thought he would be an outstanding pitcher. But when you watch a guy's first full year and he's getting banged around the way Maddux did, I mean, are you thinking that's a 300 game winner?
No chance. And Maddux wanted that call right there too for strike three against the opposing pitcher in his first game ever. Didn't matter.
Got it anyway.
90% what I learned in the game was from Maddux. He was my mentor. He was an example for me, and you know, I learned a lot from him. He's the way he prepared for the game, the way he performs, the way he go in the game. That I learned from him.
So when you misidentified the groom a couple of years ago. In the air, Sammy coming on, couldn't find it initially. Now he does so. And somebody's got to pick up his lid.
When you run a business in Chicago, you have to be ready to put in the hours, put in the work, brave the elements. Running a business here comes with ups and downs. The downs make you tougher. The ups keep you pushing. At Wintrust, we know what that's like because we started here too, with one small location and have found a way forward. No one knows how to support a Chicago business like another. From us to you, keep going. We've got your back.
Allow us to reintroduce ourselves. A new retro-inspired look for the Great American Lager. This bud's for you.
This is the Frells family's land. When the first snow fell, the kids went sledding right there. This used to be a shed. Now, it's where they get breakfast. This is more than just land. It's home. The Frells family runs with us on a John Deere 1 Series tractor. This land isn't the only thing that should live on for generations. Nothing runs like a deer. Search John Deere 1 Series for more. Get a 1 Series tractor starting at $99 per month.
When America's service members move forward, they're unstoppable. Unstoppable in their mission. Since 2003, Wounded Warrior Project has advocated for these heroes. Our mission is helping injured veterans achieve their highest ambition with free services in mental health, career counseling, and long-term rehabilitative care. And warriors never pay a penny for our programs. They're unstoppable heroes. Support warriors today at woundedwarriorproject.org.
Great weather, great friends. You just saved a bunch of money by switching your boat insurance to Geico. It was easy.
Folks, can it get any better than this?
Is that what I think it is?
That is an armada of tiny sushi boats.
Awesome! I forgot to pack lunch!
You had one job. Oh, chopsticks, wasabi, and soy. Coming in a little hot.
It only gets better when you switch and save with Geico.
Front seats. Back seats. Actually, more back seats. The versatility of available third row seating in the Discovery Sport. Land Rover, above and beyond. The Discovery Sport, with ClearSight rearview mirror. The only adventure sales event is happening now. Land Rover, above and beyond.
2016 Run for the Ring on Marquee Sports Network is proudly presented by Toyota, Budweiser, and Prevagen.
Three-two ball game. The Giants got one in the opening inning. A sac fly run batted in from Barry Bonds. Got a pair in the third on singles by Alfonso. A double by Pierzynski. The Cubs got two back in the fourth inning on a two-run double by Todd Walker. And now Nomar Garciaparra drops a base hit down the left field line. Bonds able to cut it off. But into second base goes Nomar with a leadoff double representing the tying run. His second hit today.
Well, Nomar is a first pitch hacker. You should come nowhere near the strike zone on the first pitch. He's got more hits than anybody on the first pitch. Look at the balance through his swing. He goes up there ready. He wants to hit the first pitch.
When you talk about extra base hit power for a middle infielder, especially a shortstop, over 40% of his 1,290 career hits have been for extra bases. Tyler Walker will start to get loose in the Giant bullpen. A much maligned Giant bullpen. That pitch in the dirt gets away from Pierzynski. Got away from him twice.
He kicked it. You know, Tom, just to illustrate what I was talking about with Garciaparra, in the last 7 years, he's got 340 hits on the first pitch. And we're talking about first pitch hackers, guys like Vlad Guerrero and Vinny Castilla.
And this guy right here.
Moises Alou will go up there hacking. Garrett Anderson. You know, you're talking about some classic guys that go up and do not waste any time. Garcia has more hits in the last 7 years than any of those guys on the first pitch. Now, why would you throw him anything close?
One and one to Moises Alou. Pulled hard into left field. Bonds racing back. He's got it. And back to second goes Garciaparra. What a way in the inning. Well, here comes Sammy Sosa.
Hennessy has been in control of his emotions and has been in control of his pitches. Done a nice job today pitching. And I would assume he'd approach Sammy in much the same way as he did before.
Again, Pierzynski set up away in a bluff throw back to second base, where Garciaparra represents a tying run here in the top of the fifth. Well, for the first time since Sosa became a Chicago Cub, he has heard some boos this season at Wrigley Field. The expectations so high for this Cub team coming into the year. After getting to the NLCS last season, swung on and fouled away. Now, they have been hurt badly this year by injuries. There's no debate about that. But even the most hardcore Cub fan will tell you, with 2 months left to go and this team almost completely healthy now, it would be inexcusable, or put it this way, it would be a major disappointment if the Cubs do not reach the playoffs. They have a favorable schedule, they have everybody back, and they lead in the wild card. And Sosa grounds it to third. Two away in the inning. Garcia Parra led off the inning with a double, and he's still stuck there at second base.
I have not seen Sammy Sosa be this pull happy in the last 7 or 8 years of his career, standing that far off the plate and trying to pull everything. The little toe tap that he uses to set up his swing, but just a little bit too much spinning on that back leg. As we talked in his earlier at bat, he is best and became a complete hitter when he learned how to go the other way, and he's gone away from that this season.
Now Aramis Ramirez, who doubled down the right field line, broke his bat his last time up, scored the first Cub run. Looks at ball one, low and away. Well, Hennessy trying to pitch out of major trouble when you consider the people that he had to face after a leadoff double by Garcia Parra. He got a Lou on a liner to left, Sosa on a grounder to third. 1-0-2 Ramirez is ball two.
Boy, I would be very careful with Ramirez right now in this situation if I'm Hennessy's. Behind in the count, two balls and no strikes. I would not give in and not worry if I walked him. I'd rather face Lee.
Terrific breaking ball there on a 2-0 pitch. Well, there aren't a lot of youngsters coming up making their major league debut throwing 2-0 breaking balls for strikes. That's big league pitch.
That was the scouting report. Can throw that slider for a strike anytime he wants.
And then a fastball paints the outside corner, strike two. Ramirez has something to say to Ted Barrett.
Paint the corner. Look at Brzezinski setting up, framing it. Good pitch.
Tying run at second base. Two away. 2-2 pitch to Ramirez. Fouled out of play off to the right side.
I asked A.J. Brzezinski what he was going to do to keep Hennessy in the ballgame. He said, I was just going to try to keep him calm. Knows how to pitch. He's got good numbers as you look so far in this ballgame. This is my job, just to keep him in the ballgame. Calm him down. Look at Brzezinski as he's waiting. Just letting him settle down before he has to throw the next pitch.
On the ground in the center field, a base hit, and we are tied as Garcia Parra comes home on the base hit by Aramis Ramirez.
Setting up for the slider away. Look at the location there, though. He just hung it, left it out over the plate. Well, it is amazing. And when you play the game, you don't really realize. You come up here and sit and do games like I'm doing now after playing for 13 years. It is amazing the difference that it takes for a good pitch, a slider that hits the outside part of the plate, and you get guys out. And if you miss by 3 or 4 inches and leave it out over the middle of the plate, it gets hit and hit hard.
Now Greg Maddux, who fell behind 3-0, has watched his team come back to tie it. His second try today for his 300th career win up against Tennessee, making his big league debut. One and oh to Derek Lee, pitch on the way and fouled out of play.
That is hot, too.
That ball hammered into deep right center field. Back to the wall and off against the bricks. Ricochets to Grissom. On his way to third is Ramirez. And he will score. And the Cubs have given Greg Maddux a 4-3 lead here in the fifth inning.
Another ball left in the middle of the plate. Watch Brzezinski's reaction as soon as he sees it. Watch him tap his glove saying, that's not where I wanted it. And a great job by Grissom on the carom off the wall. Look at the positioning of Marquise Grissom. Didn't matter, couldn't get the ball in time to cut down the run at the plate. But Grissom does a better job than anybody in this ballpark of knowing where the ball's gonna bounce off the wall.
Big two out hits here in the Cub fifth inning by Ramirez and Lee to Chase Hennessy. Cubs four, Giants three. Walker comes on from the pen. And now Felipe Alou turns it over to his bullpen. And boy, this has been a bunch. It has been knocked around on a regular basis over the last month. Tyler Walker, the rookie right-hander, comes on. His 36th game. They've got a handful of pitchers that are on pace to pitch in 75 or more games, including Jim Brouwer, who's on pace to pitch over 90 games.
Hey, look at the final numbers from Brad Hennessy, who did a nice job. We saw as he started to tire in this inning of the ball starting to sail out over the middle of the plate and was unable to keep location with them.
He did a good job.
Yes, he did.
I mean, he handled himself well. His major league debut. I mean, just think of all the butterflies and how nervous you are just on that alone. And then you're going up against a guy that Hennessy told us yesterday watched all the time as a kid. I mean, the Cubs played on a superstation. The Braves played on a superstation. So watch Maddux just about every single start. 2-2 to Walker.
Sure as heck is talking to the right guy after his start next to Jason Schmidt there. Noah Lowry on the other side of Schmidt. Schmidt leading candidate probably at this point in the season for the Cy Young Award.
2-2 to Todd Walker, runner at second, Cubs leading by a run, and a pitch check swing. They appeal down to third, and Ed Roccuano said he didn't go around. Full count.
Well, I think Walker right here is looking dead red. And if he doesn't get it, he might spin himself right into the ground trying to swing at it.
He swung at it and won the fastball. Barry Bonds and the Giants have fallen behind for the first time. 4-3, Bonds due up 30 in the fifth.
It's about winning championships. It's about holding yourself accountable to the things that you've found in winning. You know, I've been a part of winning almost my entire life, and I know what that looks like. And those are the expectations that I'm going to hold those guys accountable to.
I'm Javi Baez, and you're watching Marquee Sports Network.
Mom, why is this guy doing that?
Get in the house, son.
Now!
We plan on broadcasting from this frequency as long as we're able.
The whole world's waiting for your solution.
Everything's gonna be just fine.
You found its weakness?
I found our strength. And the best part is, we've been carrying it the whole time.
Game, set, match.
I know, right?
Don't waste your time and money at the chain store. They got the best auto parts. Brake parts, suspension parts, and dealer parts too. The website's so easy to use. The lowest prices and fast delivery too. All the parts your car will ever need. All the savvy folks are buying parts at rockauto.com. All the parts your car will ever need. rockauto.com.
Is it riskier to build your way to growth or buy your way? We have ideas. Find them at wehaveideas.firstmidwest.com. First Midwest Bank. How will the tight labor market affect your bottom line? We have ideas. Find them at wehaveideas.firstmidwest.com. First Midwest Bank.
The network has to be prepared to absorb whatever is going to come its way.
We're always preparing.
Make sure that the network is working all the time.
We are constantly looking at it. We're constantly monitoring. Take that responsibility very seriously.
The most rewarding thing about the work we do is whenever we see a customer able to communicate back to their loved ones.
That is why we do what we do.
We're relentlessly committed to the network. So in times like this, America can stay connected to work, school, and most importantly, to each other.
We've always had villains to face.
Bad guys to take down. But you?
You're worse than all of them put together. You are the most horrible of all.
Pure evil.
But just because you're tough
doesn't mean we can't beat you.
We're not here because we have to be. We're here because we've had enough of you.
Every single one of us is mortal.
Even me. But inside of us, we're all heroes. One person is not a team.
But when we join together...
Together. You don't stand a chance.
We are glorious. We are resilient.
And we will win.
So stand up with us. Stand up to fight.
To stand up to cancer. Visit standuptocancer.org to learn more.
Greg Maddux hoping for the Midas touch over the final five innings here today and looking to pick up win number 300 in his marvelous major league career.
You talked about it earlier, Tom, not letting Maddux settle in. He has not had his best stuff today.
Fly ball in the right center by Ricky Lede, and Patterson is there to corral it. One gone here in the fifth.
But you sure as heck don't win 300 games in the big leagues by being a guy who can't win without his best stuff and being a guy who doesn't smell blood when you get the chance. With your team now leading this game 4-3, you may see Maddux settle down and throw two of his best innings to finish up.
.300 wins, a level reached by only 21 pitchers in major league history. This season, of course, Maddux returning to the Cubs, the club that originally drafted him after signing as a free agent very late on February the 18th. Steve mentioned earlier, Maddux the first pitcher ever to win 15 or more games in 16 consecutive years. And during that 16-year span, he has led the major leagues in wins and innings pitched, and second only to Pedro Martinez in earned run average. To think that over 16 years, Maddux an earned run average in a hitter-friendly era of 2.76 and 13 gold gloves. Ho hum.
Greg Maddux was like no other player or teammate I played with. You know, what I appreciate about him the most was actually I was hurt most of the time that he was here. So I really got a chance to see how he went about his business in between starts and the amount of time and effort he put in and video and watching. And not only that, just the things that he paid attention to while he was watching video. It was different from the rest of us. He would pick up little things that most of us didn't even think to look at. And he would take it out and try to utilize it and take advantage of it. So just how smart he was with his studying and with his preparation and the fact that I don't think his pulse ever got above 75.
Tom Brenneman, Steve Lyons, our entire Fox crew here at SBC Park in San Francisco, where the story today is Greg Maddux looking for his 300th career win, fell behind 3-0. The Cubs have come back to give him a 4-3 lead. And now Barry Bonds on the first pitch to right center field. Sammy is there, and Maddux sails through a 1-2-3 pick, his first.
People from Chicago pull for Chicago. We root for his teams, celebrate his successes, push through his challenges. When people call us the second city, it's misleading. We're second to none. We're hardworking, resilient, but we have a good time. When you live in Chicago, you proudly call this home. Your bank should too. We're Wintrust, built here for here. And we've taken our place as Chicago's bank because no other bank can say the same.
This is the Frells family's land. When the first snow fell, the kids went sledding right there. This used to be a shed. Now, it's where they get breakfast. This is more than just land. It's home. The Frells family runs with us on a John Deere 1 Series tractor. This land isn't the only thing that should live on for generations. Nothing runs like a deer. Search John Deere 1 Series for more. Get a 1 Series tractor starting at $99 per month.
Allow us to reintroduce ourselves. A new retro-inspired look for the Great American Lager. This bud's for you.
Hello world, here's the road that we're taking. Come on, get healthy.
Working together, there's a goal that we're making to keep us healthy.
With the new LiveWell app from Advocate Aurora, it's easy to make healthy happen anytime, anywhere.
Traveling along,
here's a place that we're going.
Come on, get healthy. Come on, get healthy.
The 2016 Run for the Ring on Marquee Sports Network is proudly presented by Jim Beam, Menards, and the Bob LaCurcio Auto Group.
Tyler Walker on in relief of Brad Hennessy, who allowed four runs in his 4 2/3 innings. Cubs got two in the fourth, two in the fifth to give Greg Maddux this one-run lead. Maddux drew up second behind Paul Bacco, then the leadoff man Corey Patterson. Bacco 0 for 2 has bounced to first, flied out to left. 1-1. A fair ball, little cue shot down to left field line. It'll be extra bases for Bacco as a fan leans out and taps it. And a ground rule double for Bacco to begin the sixth inning. Well, a moment ago, Steve had a chance to catch up with Giants manager Felipe Alou.
Felipe, obviously, as a father, you got to be very proud to have your son playing in the big leagues, but how tough is it playing against him?
Well, I'm proud that he's a tough man, you know, number one, and I'm proud that he's a good ball player, too. And three, yes, he's in the big leagues, but he's been in the big league for a long, long time and been a very productive guy, a tough guy.
Felipe, what one area of your ball club has to improve for you to win this wild card or catch the Dodgers in the National League West?
Well, you know, we have two kids now in the rotation, you know. We need to get more innings, sorry about this, more innings from the starting pitchers. So that's why the reason I'm bullpen, my dog was a little tired and in disarray a couple of times.
Felipe, thank you for your time.
You're welcome.
Greg Maddux steps up there and drops down his eighth sacrifice of the year. It was bunted so hard, Alfonso turned around to look to third. Bacco does not run well, but Davey Cruz doesn't run well either.
Yeah. Watch the replay and where Davey Cruz at shortstop is and how he has to get over there. You see both of them matched up at the same time on a little bit of a wheel play. Defensively for the Giants, Cruz has to get over there about five steps earlier than he did.
Well, you got to wonder if Maddux is okay over there talking to the Cub trainer in the dugout. Maddux left after six innings. We talked about his last start. This ball hammered off the bat of Corey Patterson, and it is long gone into the Cubby Cove. Patterson, number 13. And the Cubs extend their lead. It's now 6-3.
Patterson jumping all over a first pitch. Fastball knows it's gone. So does Tyler. Patterson's one of those guys that the Cubs project to be a 25 to 35 run home run hitter. as he develops into his career, just needs to cut down on the strikeouts. Got him hitting leadoff right now, mostly out of necessity, but they see him as a middle of the order guy, maybe a little bit longer.
How do you like Maddux's chances now? He's only 136 games over 500 when he gets five runs or more behind him. That's pretty good.
Well, as we said before, too, when you start to smell blood, when you're a guy that's been there 300 times before, he went out and had a six-pitch inning last inning.
1-1 to Garcia Parra. And a soft liner to second baseman Ray Durham for the second out here in the sixth. Johan Santana on the mound in that one today for Minnesota. What a year he's had.
Every day he goes out there, he throws seven or eight innings, gives up three hits, one run, no runs. Been amazing.
Oh, and one to Moise Salou. Two down, two in, nobody on. Lewis hit the ball right on the screws twice in three at bats. Back in the third, a liner right at Marquise Grissom in center. Then lined out to Bonds, his last at bat in the fifth. 1-2.
That's a pitch right there, a little cutter, a little slider on the outer half of the plate that will give Alou trouble. For my money, as you watch the replay of that pitch, pinpoint location, he still has the quickest hands of any guy on the Cubs team. If you try to throw him inside.
So they go outside and get him swinging. Greg Maddux coming right out of that dugout. Stake to a 3-1 lead after the 2-1 bomb into the bay by Patterson.
A typical day at Wrigley Field.
As Chicago natives would say, it was a beautiful early May day.
A flame-throwing Cubs rookie.
We have a treat for you today. Youngster from Texas will take the mound.
A game that made history.
What can you say?
This is what everybody comes for, to hopefully come to that special game.
Here comes the hook. Down in 20 strikeouts.
Kerry Wood 20, Friday at 6 on Marquee Sports Network.
Bad hair day? Try no hair day. And at least you can check in on mine, walk into a Supercuts and get a fresh haircut. You know what happens when I walk into a Supercuts?
I don't.
They just assume I'm looking for the karate studio next door. This guy knows what I'm talking about.
Yeah.
Are you in a job you can't stand? Do you want a rewarding career with great growth potential?
What a career in IT means to me is unlimited options. Before my computer career, I was struggling to make ends meet.
You don't have to have any form of IT experience when you walk into this campus.
They guide you every step of the way to help you find your dream job.
I want this, and I can do this.
Train for a better life at mycomputercareer.edu. Go to mycomputercareer.edu and fill out the free career evaluation right now.
Someday these will be the good old days.
It's about winning championships. It's about holding yourself accountable to the things that you've found in winning. You know, I've been a part of winning almost my entire life, and I know what that looks like. And those are the expectations that I'm going to hold those guys accountable to.
You're watching Marquee Sports Network.
Ah, the census. A special time when we count every person in each home in every neighborhood.
Do kids count?
Of course. Counting everyone in your home helps support your neighborhood by funding things like schools, hospitals, and buses. Complete the census by calling or going online, or return your form by mail.
It's easy, secure, and most important, it's totally private.
Make your family count!
This year, make sure every child counts. Visit 2020census.gov.
Greg Maddux climbs the hill, takes the ball, turns it loose to begin the bottom of the sixth inning, now with a 6-3 lead. He's retired the last seven batters since giving up the RBI double to A.J. Pierzynski in the two-run third. 78th pitch of the game by Maddux is hit sharply, knocked down by Ramirez, but he can't find it. That'll be an infield hit undoubtedly for Edgardo Alfonso, his third hit today.
Ramirez mad at himself only because he couldn't find the ball. This is a bullet, one hopper hit at him, eats him up. Great view of it here. Great effort to make the play, and now he just can't find it. I think that's why they call it the hot corner.
Now A.J. Pierzynski, who just missed homering his last time up in the fifth inning, when he doubled to knock in a run into right center field. A ball and a strike.
Pierzynski this season, coming over from Minnesota, got off to such a slow start with the Giants. Big adjustment to playing in this big ballpark. Clearly a pitcher's park. Daytime the ball travels a little bit better. I asked him if the park started getting in his head a little bit. He said, I'd hit my best bolt, wouldn't go anywhere. But he said, you know, it wasn't really the ballpark. He said, I was just crappy. He said, now I've started to swing the bat a little bit better.
Well, he had a monster month of July. As you get a look at the Cub bullpen, busy here. Maddux has reached the 80 pitch mark. That ball hammered down the right field line, but foul. Well, the left-hander Kent Merker, the right-hander John Lester getting warmed up. Maddux had back-to-back complete games in the middle of July. Nine innings, a six-hit shutout against Milwaukee. Then went nine innings, allowed four hits, two runs to beat Cincinnati. His last two starts, six innings. Base hit center field, and here come the Giants. Runners at first and second, and nobody out. Larry Walchild, the pitching coach for the Cubs, going to come out and visit with Maddux and Paul Bacco. Back-to-back base hits by Alfonso and Pierzynski to start this sixth inning. And that's going to be it for Greg Maddux. He's gone five innings, which would qualify him to get his 300th win. But the bullpen going to have to nail it down over the final four innings.
Maddux is not usually accustomed to picking up wins after pitching only five innings, the minimum for a starting pitcher to qualify. In fact, Maddux finished his career with 355 victories. Only 25 of those wins were five-inning starts. Now the professor will need a little help from the bullpen to become just a 22nd pitcher to reach that 300-win milestone.
Very warm reception for Greg Maddux from the crowd here in San Francisco. As he leaves after five plus innings, Steve, his last at bat when he put down a sacrifice in the top of the sixth inning. We saw Maddux talking with a Cubs trainer down in their dugout. And again, this is all speculation, but you just got to wonder if he's all right.
I don't think he is. He's only thrown 81 pitches in this game. It's the chance to win his 300th. And you look at the numbers on John Lester, has been outstanding, but all due respect to him, Greg Maddux does not hand the ball over to anybody after 81 pitches in the sixth inning if he's healthy. Has not had his greatest stuff today, has battled through this entire game, but Maddux doesn't come out in this situation unless he's not healthy.
Two on and nobody out. Marquise Grissom, the batter, 6-3. The Cubs lead it. We're in the bottom of the sixth inning, and a strike one to Grissom, who was grounded to third and struck out. Fouled out of play, 0-2. Well, here's what we were talking about after Maddux put down the bunt. Reaching over and feeling the forearm or the wrist. I don't know, maybe just wiping it off. But talking about something with a trainer.
Trainers aren't guys you really like to talk to that much.
No. They say Grissom went around, and that's strike three. On the appeal down to Lance Barksdale, the first base umpire.
Grissom making the offering at the pitch. Definitely a strike.
Now Davey Cruz, a batter. Number eight hitter in the lineup, has bounced to short and grounded to third. Ball one low. A pinch hitter has moved into the on-deck circle.
That's why I'm a little bit surprised that they weren't bunting in that situation with Grissom to try to move the runners over. You let Cruz take a crack at it. You know you're going to bring a pinch hitter up for the pitcher anyway. You got to get or try to get a run back in this game.
Popped up behind the plate and out of play. Lester throwing the ball so well for the Cubs right now. They had a decision to make when they activated Ryan Dempster, who pitched in the game here last night. Less than a year after coming back from reconstructive elbow surgery, Todd Wellemeyer was having a fabulous year for the Cubs, but Lester just a little bit better. So he stayed and Wellemeyer left. 2-1 to Cruz. Told you a pinch hitter has come out into the on deck circle. That would be Michael Tucker for the time being. Hammered foul. Two on, nobody out, one out. And the 2-2 pitch is outside. Full count to Davey Cruz.
That was a good location for that pitch. Lester trying to get a double play ball out of Davey Cruz. Most ironic thing about the Cub defense is that they're second overall in defense and have turned the fewest double plays of anybody in the league. That's an ironic stat to go together.
Bouncer off the glove of Ramirez, making the turn and coming home is Alfonso. And now it's a two-run ball game as Davey Cruz knocks in his 25th run of the season.
Cruz just beaten down on that ball, gets the high hopper. Ramirez can't come up with it. Ramirez jumping as high as he can, gets it off the webbing of his glove and can't keep it in. Alfonso taking a good look at it, and after the ball gets past, Ramirez knows that he's going to try to score.
Now Dusty Baker going to summon the left-hander Kent Merker to face Michael Tucker. We'll see if he bats after all. Two on, one in. Giants trailing the Cubs 6-4 here in the bottom half of the sixth inning. Now Michael Tucker was announced as the pinch hitter. Dusty Baker made the decision to bring on the left-hander Kent Merker. And now Felipe Alou will counter with Pedro Feliz to bat for Tucker. Interesting that Tucker would be taken down in his career against Merker. He has four hits and seven at bats. Feliz against Merker is 0 for 3. But Feliz, the kind of guy that can give the Giants a one-run lead with one swing of the bat. Feliz's playing time has pretty much dwindled down to nothing. And yet he has his second most home runs on the team and ranks in the top four and runs batted in.
Led this team in RBIs at one point in the season.
Pierzynski and Cruz aboard. And it's low and away to Pedro Feliz.
Merker said he figured to get in this game at some point with the left-handed hitting Giants at the top of the order. And now Feliz being the pinch hitter at the back end of it.
Bringing the foul ball back out of play. 1-2 to Pedro Feliz.
Want to be a big league catcher? Hello. That hurts a lot worse when you're the guy with the mask on.
Fastball up in the zone, and Feliz chases it, comes up empty. So now 1-2 on Feliz. This guy is almost impossible to walk.
There's that pitch coming right into your living room.
Well, now Mercury, he's been around a long time. He'll expand that strike zone. Only 14 walks all year for Feliz. He wouldn't chase that one again. And it's 2-2. Felipe Alou making the comment that Feliz is going to have to be a corner infielder the rest of his career. That one hooked foul. He's a versatile player. He's playing the outfield. He got a number of starts at shortstop early in the year when they were juggling some people due to injuries to Ray Durham and JT Snow. But they're locked into a big contract for two more years with Edgardo Alfonso down at third, and they brought JT Snow back again to play first. So Feliz, a guy who, to be quite honest about it, when playing, does far more offensive damage than either one of those players, Snow or Alfonso. Doesn't get the starts.
He's always been the guy that the Giants think they're going to give a chance to play every day and then doesn't get that opportunity. Odd man out always.
Fly ball center field. Patterson's got it. And the runners stay at first and second. Two gone in the inning. Now Ray Durham, for the first time today, turns around to bat right-handed. Went 1-for-3 against Maddux, led off the bottom of the first inning with a triple and scored. Durham hitting .321 as a right-handed batter. .254 from the other side. Strike one from Merker.
It was a lot of fun to be in that Cub dugout earlier before the ball game, and you look at the mentality of a relief pitcher like Merker. Him and Glendon Rush doing a good job, the left-handers out of that pen, and how they think the ways they can get into a game. He saw the left-handers and, of course, Durham, the switch hitter, but then Lede and Snow said, that's my opportunity to get in this ball game, and now you see it realized. He said, guys used to joke with him all the time when he was a starter. Steve Bedrosian used to say, when he was the long man on the team, when they played together, he'd look at Merker during his starts and say, oh, you're pitching today? I guess that means I'm going to be pitching too.
Two and one to Durham. And popped up. Playable for Walker, and that'll do it. Giants get one back. Trail by two. Sammy and the Cubs coming up after a break.
Cadillac invites you to move up in the world at the Cadillac Move Up sales event. Move up to available Wi-Fi hotspot capability. Move up to cutting-edge design. Move up to something a little more, well, Cadillac. Make your way to your nearest Cadillac showroom today. During the Move Up sales event, get this low-mileage lease on this 2020 Cadillac XT5 for around $419 per month.
We are T-Mobile, the first to go unlimited. First with no annual service contracts. First with taxes and fees included. Now T-Mobile has the first and only nationwide 5G network, reaching over 5,000 cities and towns and over 200 million Americans. And T-Mobile is not charging extra for 5G access. Because this isn't our network, it's yours.
When you run a business in Chicago, you have to be ready to put in the hours, put in the work, brave the elements. Running a business here comes with ups and downs. The downs make you tougher. The ups keep you pushing. At Wintrust, we know what that's like because we started here too, with one small location and have found a way forward. No one knows how to support a Chicago business like another. From us to you, keep going. We've got your back.
Allow us to reintroduce ourselves. A new retro-inspired look for the Great American Lager. This bud's for you.
Are you in a job you can't stand and are working too many hours for too little money? Do you want a rewarding career with great growth potential? By attending My Computer Career, in as little as 4 months, you could be starting your new career in the growing IT field. Classes meet on campus or live online just twice a week. Go to mycomputercareer.edu and fill out the free career evaluation right now. You don't need to be a math or computer whiz. At mycomputercareer.edu, and no experience necessary. At mycomputercareer.edu.
Do you have concerns about mild memory loss related to aging? Prevagen is the number one pharmacist-recommended memory support brand. You can find it in the vitamin aisle in stores everywhere. Prevagen, healthier brain, better life.
Top half of the seventh inning we go. A 6-4 Cubs lead over the Giants. Sammy Sosa to start things against a new pitcher, Matt Hergis. Hergis began the year as a Giants closer, something he had never done before. And you see, he got 23 of them. But an ERA of up over 5.5. Dustin Hermanson came on to close out the ball game here last night. And the Giants looking for any combination of pitchers just to get outs. His bullpen has struggled mightily over the last month.
It's like a double-edged sword for the bullpen because the starters on this team have not gone deep into games, so the bullpen has been overworked. You get overworked, you get a little bit tired, and you're not going to admit that you're tired. You don't get guys out, you're not as sharp. You get up in the pen and don't get into ball games. You get up a couple times in a game and don't get in. Your arm's hanging halfway through the season.
One, two delivery. And a fastball is on the outside corner. Strike three called. Sosa has struck out for the third time today.
I think clearly for the Cubs, this is one of the things that they wanted to do was get into this Giants pen, knowing how poor they've been over the last few weeks.
Steve, as you look at this wild card race, and the Cubs come into play today, one game better than San Diego, two better than the Giants, and there are others, I mean, more than a handful of others that feel like at this point they have a legitimate